Good. Now we're learning a sicha from the Rebbe and Chelek Lamed Aleph about the splitting of the sea. When the Jewish people went to the sea, and the sea split, so it was a big relief for them. It drowned all of their enemies. And they were basically, that was the first time they were truly out of Egypt. And they sang a song. They sang a song, and they sang a very long, beautiful song. And the song is written in the book of Exodus, in Parshat Bashalach. That's what this is. And it was a long, beautiful song. And it says all the Jewish people all sang it together. There's different opinions exactly how it was that sang it together, and we'll talk about this. But right near the end of this beautiful song that they all sang together, as they sang the sentence, Mikdash Hashem Konen Yodecha, the holy temple of God will be established by your hands. They're speaking to God. They're praising God. The holy temple of God will be established by your hands. Okay. This, generally speaking, is talking about the third temple that will be built by God. Really? Not so clear. Let's see. Now, before we start this, there's a basic principle in the Torah. The Torah was given by God to the Jewish people. It's not an addition to the world. The world, in a way, is an addition to the Torah. In other words, the Torah existed before the world was created. And according to the mysteries of the Torah, the letters of the Torah and the ideas of the Torah, and the principles of the Torah, the world was created. The Torah is called the blueprint for the world. And just to stress this, God gave the Torah in front of about 3 million witnesses in Mount Sinai. And when he did, the whole world sort of evaporated. And everyone saw clearly that this was the Creator speaking. And in fact, that's one of the Ten Commandments. The fourth of the Ten Commandments is that God created the heavens and the earth. 6 days, God created the heavens and the earth. That's the fourth of the Ten Commandments. And the second of the Ten Commandments is you're not allowed to believe in any other God. That's talking about all of mankind. Only the God that created and is creating all of the heavens and the earth, because time is also a creation. So God creates time. So everything is being constantly created. So God also, the first of the Ten Commandments is God took the Jews out of Egypt. And of course, the whole basis of the Ten Commandments is that it's the Torah telling us that God, I am the one giving you these Ten Commandments. I am giving you the Torah, God. So he chose the Jews and he took them out of Egypt. He's active in the world and he creates the world. God creates the world and he gave the Torah. But the interesting thing about the Torah is like God. You can't understand the Torah. You can't understand the Torah. What do you mean you can't understand the Torah? The Torah, every word and every idea in the Torah is a miracle. And the biggest miracle of all is that you can understand some of it. And in fact, it was given to be understood. But amazingly enough, God wanted there to be arguments in the Torah. Of course, these arguments are only by men that are totally devoted to the Torah. They're totally devoted to God. Men that are devoted every instant of their lives to the Creator and understanding the Holy Torah and what the Holy Torah is trying to tell us about fixing the creation. Because that's the purpose of the Torah, is in order to make the world into the place that God wants it. And the Torah tells us what God wants. So here's an example of one of these arguments that's in the Torah. Then it says that in the normal world, if two people have opposite opinions, the one is right and one is wrong. According to the Torah, it could be two people have opposite opinions. One opinion is the accepted one, and both of them are true. Both of them are the word of God. That's in the Talmud and the Midrash, the Mishnah, Halacha. All these people who are genuinely devoted to the Torah of Moses. Well, here's an example. It says in the Torah, Mikdash Hashem, Konan Yodecha. It says in the Torah that the holy temple of God, your hands made. Your hands made. Itab Mechilta, it says in the Mechilta, it's brought in Rashi, that Chaviv Beit HaMikdash Lifnei HaKodesh Baruch Hu, Kishabura HaKodesh Baruch Hu et HaOlamo, the Beit HaMikdash is very dear. The Holy Temple is very dear in front of God, because when God created the world, Lo Baro Ela Biyado Echad, he only created it with one hand. Shenemar Af Yedi Es Ta'oretz, my hand made the earth. When God wanted to create the holy temple, kiviyachol, so to speak, it was with two hands. Why does it say kiviyachol, so to speak? Because God doesn't have hands like we do. But on the other hand, it says man is created in God's image. So God does have some sort of hands. The reason for saying these things is that God has hands and he has a mouth and he has eyes, the eyes of God. It says under his feet of God, is to tell us that God is not amorphous. God is not this indescribable blob of nothingness and oneness and light and that he's completely removed from the world. But he creates the world. He created the world, whatever. It's a level of consciousness. That's the God of the Hindus, the God of Spinoza, of these people. He doesn't really care about the world, doesn't give commandments. He's not really connected to man, doesn't really make any difference to him what man does or not. You get the point, you get it. You don't get the point, you don't get it. There's no real good or bad. That's not the God. That's not our God. That's not the God of Israel. The God of Israel is in Kelokin. There's nothing like our God. The God of Israel is very, very, how do you want to call it, human. He really cares. He gets angry. He has love. He helps. He's kind. He's involved, intimately involved in every detail of the creation. That idea was brought forth, especially as stressed by the Baal Shem Tov. It's called Hashgacha Pratit, that God cares about every detail, and he directs every detail, and every detail is interconnected with every other detail. So it says, but nevertheless, as amazing and important as the world is to God, even more important is the Holy Temple. Because the Holy Temple, so to speak, God made with two hands. Shinemar, like it says, Mikdash Hashem Konon Nedetecha, like it says, the temple of God, your hands, it doesn't say Yodecha, Yodecha. Eimotai Tivneh, when will God make the Holy Temple? Well, it says right after that in the sentence in the Bible, it says, Hashem Imloch Lolam Voed, when God will rule forever and ever. Lati Labo in the future, Shekol Malucha Shalom. That all of the kingship will be his. Now, as it is in the world, there's all sorts of people and ideas and idols and false ideas and false gods that tell us about how important heaven is and going to heaven. You're going to go to heaven. Heaven. People's thinking about obsessed with going to heaven all the time and how false this world is and a lie the world. Well, the Mashiach is going to show that itself is really false. The real true truth is this world and the revealing the godliness in the world. Then it says that God will be a king in this physical world. That's going to be when the temple is built. It means that God is going to build a temple. In the Gomorrah, Isa, it says, Gadola Masa Tzadikim, the deeds of the Tzadikim are greater than the heavens and the earth. It doesn't say that the Holy Temple is greater than the heavens and the earth. This is the deeds of the tzaddikim, of the righteous Jews. They are greater than the heavens and the earth. Like it says, Af yedi yistaoretz, because it says, my hand made the world, my hand, yamina tipchin, and my right hand made the heavens. And the hand, the deeds of the tzaddikim, it says, the same sentence, machon l'shivtecha Hashem, mikdash Hashem konon yodecha. It says, Mikdash, the holy ones, God, your hands have established. Same sentence. But here it says that it's talking about not the holy temple, but about the tzaddikim. And Rashi says, Mikdash, the holy temple, or the is maiset tzaddikimu, is the deeds of the tzaddikim. This word, Mikdash, doesn't necessarily mean the holy temple. It means the deeds of the tzaddikim. That is the holy temple. That's what it is. It's holy. Even though this says Mikdash Hashem Konon Yodecha, doesn't say the holiness of, it says, doesn't say the holiness of Tzaddikim. It says the holiness of God. Where does Rashi get the idea that this is talking about the Tzaddikim? Maisi Yadei Tzaddikim, the deeds of the Tzaddikim, of the righteous holy Jews, are called the deeds of God. Because that's what God wants, right? He wants us to do His deeds. When we do it, then that makes God in the world. The first glance, we can say that maybe the argument between the Gomorrah, that says that this sentence is talking about the deeds of the tzaddikim. And the Mechilta, which that's a midrash, that says that this is talking about the holy temple. Right? One says the tzaddikim are more valuable than the world. And the other one says the holy temple is more valuable than the world. Maybe we can say it's talking about an argument between if the Beit HaMikdash, the third temple, will be built by means of man, or will it be built by means of God? There's an argument like that. But according to everybody, it's talking about the third temple. According to this, so we can say that that what it says, that the that Rashi on the Torah, he brings the Mechilta. And he says, why does Rashi, when he explains in the Torah, why does he bring this midrash that says that it's talking about the third temple and that God is going to build it? Because he's going according to the opinion that Bekama Makom B'Shas, and it's mentioned other places in the Talmud as well. It's mentioned in the Gemara here. It says in the Zohar, and he brings also in Sukkah, the Gemara Sukkah, and it's supposed in the Tosfos in Sukkah and Rosh Hashanah, the Gemara in Rosh Hashanah, that the third temple is going to be built by God. That the third temple is Meshuchlal, Banuy Meshuchlal, it's built and it's already finished somewhere in heaven. I don't know how it's going to be, but it's going to be revealed and it'll come from heaven. Like it says, Mikdash Hashem Konanu Yudecha. I mean, just to show you how far away we are from the truth, how far away this world is from perfection, the real truth is the Holy Temple. And the Holy Temple is there. You see it? No. Does anybody see it? Maybe other people do, but I certainly don't. A third temple is really there. It's built. Who knows how many millions of tons it weighs? And at the proper time, it's going to be revealed from heaven. No, the third temple is going to be built by God. Why do we know? Mikdash Hashem, konon yadecha. That's what Rashi says. But the Gemara, it says, no, this is not talking about Mikdash Hashem Kohen. This is talking about the deeds of the tzaddikim. That's more valuable. So maybe we can say that according to the Gemara, according to this Gemara, in any case, that it's talking about that the third temple will be built by man and not by God. Well, like we said, all opinions are the word of God. But according to this, it's a very, very difficult thing to say. Why? Because what do we say? Rashi, went on this sentence in the Torah, Rashi is the main explainer of the Torah. Rabbi Shlomo Yitzchaki, he lived about 800 years ago, 900 years ago. And Rashi, he explains in the Torah that this sentence is talking about God building the third temple. But on the other hand, Rashi, and in the Gemara, he brings down in another place regarding the third temple, he says that the Mikdash Maisa Yadei Tzadikim, he brings down that the holy temple will be built by humans. In other words, in the Torah, on this sentence in the book of Exodus, Rashi says that the third temple will be built by God. But in the Talmud, he says the third temple is going to be built by people, by the tzaddikim, exactly the opposite of what we said, that the third temple is going to be built, come down from heaven. And therefore, maybe we can say that maybe the argument is not whether the third temple will be built by heaven or by God. Maybe the argument is like this, that the argument is which holy temple is being spoken about in the Torah. When the Jewish people went across the sea, so they sang a song and they said, Mikdash, the holy house of you, God, konani yodecha, your hands will make. Who are your hands? So in the Mechilta, it's saying that God will build the third temple, right? Well, maybe everyone agrees that the third temple will be built by God. But the argument is, what is this referring to when it says, Mikdash Hashem konani yodecha? Is it referring to the third temple? Or maybe it's referring to the second and the first and the second temple, which is not the case. The Gemara, this is calling to, according to, it's talking about, no, it's talking about the first and the temple, first and the second temple, that according to all opinions, this will be built by man. This was built by man. I mean, when they sang it, it will be, it was in the future. So the first and the second temple, that was built, how long? 900 years or something after the Jews sang the song, right? The first temple was built 500 years after they sang the song. And given another 300 years or so, it was the second temple. So about 800 years, that was the two temples were built after the second temple was destroyed, and now we've been almost 2,000 years. So this, maybe we can say that the first and the second temple, which everybody agrees was built by man, that's what it was referring to. But the argument is the sentence in the Torah that says that the temple was made by your hands, is this talking about the first and second temple, and that your hands are referring to the tzaddikim, or is it referring to the third temple, and then your hands is referring to God? What is the sentence in the Bible referring to? If so, now we have another question. What's the question? Why would we say that there's an argument in the song on the sea? Why is it ambiguous if the third temple is being hinted at in this song on the sea? Or maybe it wasn't being hinted at all. Maybe it was just the first and the second temple. So what is the sentence talking about? Is it talking about the third temple that will be brought about God, but that will be built by God, and it's already built? Or is it talking about the first and second temples, that they were built by the tzaddikim, by the righteous Jews? We'll find out more about that, God willing, tomorrow.